any birthdays or anniversaries since we saw each other last?
I wish you could bring that up.
My job, brother. I hate that, I got one coming up, I owe one now. Robert's got one coming up.
Yeah, he.
I'm sure he will want one, man, too. But every year, the Lord lets us live with a blessing.
That's right.
Got your help, Ranch Steve? Well, if there's no birthdays or anniversaries, I'll close, I'll open worship service and prayer. Fathers, kneel before you, come into thy presence again, Lord. Thank you for this wonderful day and each one that's come this way, Father, to worship you in truth and in spirit. Lord, we ask you to bless our worship service, bless our messenger, Father, and give him that you would have us to know this morning, Lord. Be with those who can't be with us this morning, Father, for whatever reason, just Father, lift them up, protect them, draw them up close to you, Lord, and bring them back as soon as possible. Thank you most of all for our Savior and for his precious blood, Father, that can cleanse the sins of our world. Thank you, Father, for bringing us to this point. Thank you for what you've done for us in the past. Father, for that you're doing today and for that you're going. In Jesus' precious name. Amen.
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 Fire back there somewhere.
You sound the one out back there. Starting off from business here. Yes, number six.
I'm back home,
and wonderful homeland,
I know that.
wings of love, you will soar away.
Take a moment and leave.
There's a city of gold across the native blue. When I reach it, I'm told I'll live for a. My soul will fly over Chile, Jordan, over Jordan, on wings of love, I'll fly away, not home to lose, ain't that your turn,
but make up your mind, come on and take a moment and choose,
I got what I need. Someday, my
we can't even work our way to get to heaven.
That's right.
By the grace of God, we're saved by grace through faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. Good to see everybody this morning. Lord, give us another wonderful day today. It's been a beautiful day out this morning. The sun already shining. Might be a little bit cloudy out there right now, but the S-O-N sun shining in here this morning. Praise the Lord. We had our men's breakfast yesterday morning. It was the biggest, most that we've ever had here yesterday morning. We had somewhere between 39 and 41. Not just exactly sure. It's kind of hard to count when everybody's up stirring around and getting their food and all that stuff. But somewhere in that neighborhood. But had a great time. Everybody seemed to enjoy themselves. I enjoyed it, and I think everybody else did too. Had good fellowship there. Good, these guys came and sang and played and made some really good music yesterday morning. Brother Bobby Taylor brought us message yesterday morning, great message, enjoyed that. It was just a good day all the way around. Good to have Caden back with us this morning. He's going to help us here today. He's already helping us stay and play. But it's good to be here this morning. I don't know about everybody else, but I'm glad to be able to be in the Lord's house this morning. David said, let us be glad when we go in the house of the Lord. I'm glad to be here this morning. Glad to be a child of the King.
Amen.
Only thing we got coming up, we got our fellowship dinner and Valentine dinner coming up this next Saturday. We'll have that about 4:30 the next Saturday afternoon, so look forward to that. Invite somebody to come go with us and enjoy that time of fellowship and food and just have a good time there. We always have a good time doing that, and I know we will again this time. Look forward to that. And every Saturday evening around 4 o'clock, we have prayer. Everybody's invited, men, women, children, to come by and have prayer with us. We had a few here yesterday afternoon, met upstairs. It was kind of cold in here yesterday evening. We met upstairs, had prayer upstairs last night. But it's always a blessing to do that, to get together with God's people and share burdens one with another and take them before the Lord, because we know He hears and He answers. Continue to remember Danny's daddy in prayer. Got a message from Danny earlier this morning, said he'd had another stroke and he had pneumonia, and he's very weak, unable to be to get up and walk or anything. Said he was still could talk to him, and he didn't seem to be in any pain, but he just didn't have any strength at all. So continue to remember him. Pray for Devon and her family. They sent me a message yesterday and said she and her mother and Sarah and Chad and Caitlin and Ryan and the other little boy and Sarah's other son were all planning on being here this morning. So pray for them. They didn't make it. So I don't know what the problem was, but might have just been old devil got in the way. He does that sometimes. He hinders people. That's what he seems to do best. So remember them this morning, and also the young man that was here hunting for a place to stay. He, remember him this morning. He was going to come to church this morning. He sent me a message. Said he had an interview at Lowe's at 10 o'clock. So pray for him and his wife there. Remember them, Michelle and Jerry. Remember them. And I reckon that's everything, unless I've got something to stand with Dr. Paul. You don't ask the best on the offering. Amen. Amen. Amen.
safely through the sinking sand. It is the Christ of Calvary. This would be my prayer, dear Lord, each day to help me do the best I can. For I need thy light to guide me day and night, blessed Jesus, hold my hand. Blessed Jesus, hold my hand. Yes, I need thee every hour. Through this land, this pilgrim land, provide me thy
Blessed Jesus, hold my hand. Blessed Jesus.
where it be for I'm sure with the
He said,
praise the Lord.
He said, I, he said,
nearsighted people, which she's nearsighted, the back lens always kind of seems like oblong kind of looking. And he said, that's what they've been seeing all this time. And he said, you don't have it.
Amen.
He said, you might have it tomorrow, but you ain't got it today.
Thank you.
She might have it before too, the Lord said.
That's what she said last night. She said, you know,
cancer off my liver and off my colon. He took it away completely.
Amen.
So it's very possible that happened here. I can't say it for sure. I can say it for sure I'm a cancer on the liver and the colon.
Yeah.
I know I love the Lord
this
morning.
Amen.
Lonely years, and I had nothing, and my life had no meaning till I heard about Calvary. Then I knelt down in prayer. The Lord in my time, when I'm talking, in my eyes, and now I can see. He's in the songs that I'm singing, in my heart, his joy is ringing. Jesus is living in me. Through the valley, he's brought me. To the top of the mountain, over life, trouble sea. Now I sing to his glory, songs that tell the great story of Jesus is living in me. He's in my dream when I'm walking. In my time, when I'm talking, in my eyes, and now I can see. He's in the strong time, I'm singing, in my heart, it's joy and ringing. Jesus is living in me. Yes, my Jesus. He's living in me.
Yes. Amen.
Hey. Amen. He's going to be the teacher of books for you.
Amen.
I'm going to let you strum that guitar if you'll let me have a swig of that. Have a swig of that after that. Stage.
richest man in the world can't repay him for his wonderful love. There's not enough of anything to pay the Lord for the love that he showed for us.
That's right.
On our old rugged cross. I'm going to read to you this morning out of John chapter 17. John chapter 17, starting in verse 6 down through verse 17. John chapter 17, verse 6. As I was thinking this week, studying this week, thinking about it, I was thinking about what a blessing it is to go from day to day with the many blessings that God gives us every day. You know, we're unworthy of anything that we receive, and we receive blessing after blessing. God cares for us, He loves us, and He watches over us, and He takes care of us. You know what? He provides every need that we have. What a great blessing it is to be a child of the King. And I thought about the riches that we have because we are the children of God. You know, we're blessed because we are the children of God. We're blessed because we're obedient to the Word of God. We're blessed because we believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. That's where our blessings come from. Our blessings come from Almighty God. And I thought about the unsearchable riches of the kingdom of God. You know what? There's many, many riches in the kingdom of God. And I thought about some of the things and some of the promises that the Word of God gives us as we go down through these verses. And I thought about some of these things. And I wanted to read about the unsearchable riches of the kingdom of God. Listen, in Psalm 145, verse 3, it says, "Great is the Lord, and greatly to be praised, and His greatness is unsearchable." God's greatness is more than any of us. Our little old finite minds cannot even imagine what the greatness of God is. Our little old finite minds cannot even really picture what heaven's going to be like or what the Lord Jesus Christ looks like. Brother Marty mentioned it this morning. You know what? We may have some kind of mental image of what God looks like. We may have some kind of mental image of what the Lord Jesus Christ looked like when He was here on this earth. But you know what? It may not even be anywhere close to what we're going to see when we get there. God is a spirit. We worship Him in spirit and truth. And we may not have a clue of what He really is going to look like when we see Him. But you know what? Praise God, one day we will see Him. And one day we will know what He looks like. And one day we will understand a lot of those things that we no longer understand. It's in Romans chapter 11, verse 33 says, "O death of the riches, O the depth of the riches, both of the wisdom and the knowledge of God, how unsearchable are His judgments and His ways past finding out." How unsearchable are His judgments and His ways past finding out. You know what? We'll study the Word of God all our life. We'll pray and we'll seek God's wisdom and we'll seek God's understanding, and we still won't even come close to understanding the unsearchable judgments of Almighty God. Amen. His thoughts are not our thoughts, and His ways are not our ways. He's so far advanced and so much above anything that we can imagine. Our thoughts won't ever come close to what He's really like. Ephesians chapter 3, verse 8 says, Unto me who am less," this is Paul talking, "unto me who am less than the least of all the saints is the grace given that I should preach among the Gentiles the unsearchable riches of Jesus Christ," or unsearchable riches of Christ. Oh, listen, I want to tell you, we can talk all day long about how He blesses us, and we can talk all day long about how good He is, but you know what? We won't even come close to touching the tip of an iceberg because He's so much greater and so much more than what we can even imagine. I said I was going to read in John chapter 17, starting verse 6, said, "I have manifested Thy name unto the men which Thou gavest me out of the world. Thine they were, and Thou gavest them me, and they have kept Thy word. Now they have known that all things whatsoever Thou hast given me are of Thee. For I have given unto them the words which Thou gavest me, and they have received them, and have known surely that I came out from Thee, and they have believed that Thou didst send me. I pray for them. I pray not for the world, but for them which Thou hast given me, for they are Thine, and all mine are Thine, and Thine are mine, and I am glorified in them. And now I am no more in the world, but these are in the world, and I come to Thee. Holy Father, keep through Thine own name those whom Thou hast given me, that they may be one as we are one. While I was with them in the world, I kept them in Thy name. Those that Thou gavest me I have kept, and none of them is lost lost, but the son of perdition, that the scripture might be fulfilled. And now come out of thee, and these things I speak in the world, that they might have my joy fulfilled in them. I have given them thy word, and the world hath hated them because they are not of the world, even as I am not of the world. I pray not that thou should take them out of the world, but that thou should keep them from the evil. They are not of the world, even as I am not of the world. Sanctify them through thy truth. Thy word is truth. Father, we love you. We thank you, Lord, for this, another day that you've given, another opportunity to come together this morning to worship you and praise you. Thank you, Lord, for each one that come this way today. And I pray, God, you bless each one in a special way, that they go away from here saying it's been good to be in the house of the Lord. And now, God, I pray you'll fill me with your Holy Spirit. Just hold me up and speak through me the words you want said, that the saints might be edified and your name might be glorified. And God, we'll give you the praise and the glory for everything. In Jesus' precious name we pray. As I was thinking about those unsearchable gifts, I thought about the many things that God does for us every day. But as we go down through these verses here, we can see that God gives us eternal life. John 3:16, of course, everybody knows it by heart. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever should believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. You know what? That's a promise that we have from Almighty God, that we may have eternal life if we put our faith and our trust in the Lord Jesus Christ, in that precious blood shed on that old rugged cross, a promise from God that we might have eternal life. I can't think of a greater gift. Brother Roy talks about the unsearchable gift. Well, I can't think about a greater gift than the fact that I might have eternal life through the shed blood of the Lord Jesus Christ on the cross of Calvary. All the things this world has is not worth one little minute of eternity. We might live to be old people here, and we might have a lot of blessings, a lot of good things, Brother Steve. God gives us a lot of good things in this life, but all those are not worth anything compared to 1 minute.
Amen.
Compared to 1 minute of eternity.
Amen.
1 minute in that holy city, when we see him in that holy city.
Amen.
Praise God. I'm glad to know.
Amen.
It's all a blessing from God. In John chapter 17, verse 2, John chapter 17, verse 2 says, as thou hast given him power over all flesh, that he should give eternal life to as many as thou hast given him. You know what? Not one. Jesus Christ said, I've not lost one of them. I've not lost the very first one of them. Every one of them that thou hast given me, I've kept every one of them, and I've not lost any of them. You know what? I'm glad to know this morning, praise God, the devil can't take my salvation away.
Right.
The devil can destroy me. He might destroy my testimony. He might destroy everything that I have. He might take my family. He did Job. He took everything that they had, all of his material blessings and all the good things that God had given him. The devil might take them all away from me. But I'm glad to know this morning, praise God, he can't touch our salvation. He can't touch our soul. We're there. We're sealed to the day of redemption.
Amen.
You know what, Brother Marty? Praise God, one day the Lord's going to step out on a cloud, and we're going to hear the voice of the archangel, and the trumpet will sound. And you know what? Praise God, we'll lift up out of here and go home to be with the Lord forever. Praise God.
Amen.
Aren't you glad this morning that he gives us eternal life? John chapter 14, verse 6 says, he's the way, the truth, and the life. No man come to the Father but through Jesus Christ. He's the way. Listen, one of the riches of the kingdom of God is Jesus Christ.
Amen.
His name. Listen, I thought he gives us eternal life. He gives us his name. In verse 6 there he says, I have manifest thy name unto the men which thou gavest me out of the world. Thine they were, and thou gavest them to me, and they have kept thy word. He gives us his name. We're called over in Acts chapter 11. I believe it's Paul or Peter, one of them there. In Acts chapter 11, when they said Christians were first called Christians at Antioch, you know what? that name Christian, that's a name of God. That's God's name. Listen, we're called. He gives us His name. Listen, it's not a name to be taken lightly. I want to tell you this morning, Brother Joe, there's a lot of people call themselves Christians and they're not really Christ-like. So therefore, they make a mistake in even calling themselves Christian. Christian means Christ-like. And in Antioch, the disciples were first called a Christian at Antioch. Listen, I want to tell you, they were called Christians not because of where they was at, not because of what they were doing. They were called Christians because they were Christ-like. They had the mind of Christ. Where did they get it? They got it from Jesus Christ. Where do we get the mind of Christ? From the Word of God. I'm glad this morning, praise God, He saw fit to keep the Word of God for us for eternity. You know, there'd be a lot of things in this old world going to pass away. But the Word of God ain't never going to pass away. Listen, He gave us His name, Christian. We're called Christians if we were Christ-like. We want to be careful not to bring reproach on the name that God has given us. I've always said, and y'all always have heard me say, didn't ever want to do anything that would bring reproach on my family's name. And I certainly don't ever want to do anything that'll bring reproach on my father's name. Praise God, I'm glad to know this morning He gives us His name. And listen, another one of the riches is He gives us His word. Listen, in verse 8, He said, "For I have given them thy words." I have given them thy words. You know what? Jesus Christ came into the world to bring the word of God. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. Listen, Jesus Christ came into the world to bring the Word of God. We now know anything of God Almighty without Jesus Christ. God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, but God the Son came in the world in order that we might know God the Father. Because without God the Son, we'd have no opportunity to know God the Father. We'd have no opportunity to come to that place in our life, Brother Bill, where we could know that we know that we know that when we leave this walk of life, praise God, we can spend eternity with the Lord Jesus Christ in heaven. What a blessing. One of the many unsearchable riches of the Lord Jesus Christ, of the kingdom of God, His word. He gives us His word. They have believed that thou didst send me. Psalm 119, 105 says, "Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path." You know what? The word of God. It's good for right here where you're at today. The Word of God is good for where you're going to be tomorrow and right on down the road. The Word of God is a lamp unto our feet and a light in our path. It'll guide us and it'll lead us. And it has an answer to the problems that we encounter from day to day. The Word of God has an answer for every one of them. We might not always find them. Sometimes we search the Scripture looking for something. And you know what? We may have trouble finding it, but it's there. God's got an answer for everything that comes up in our life today. The unsearchable riches of God. And another one of the unsearchable riches is His provision. Listen, God provides for us every single day. Everything that we have because God has provided.
Amen.
In James chapter 1, verse 17, y'all heard me. I know you've heard me say it so many times, you probably already memorized it yourself. In James chapter 1, verse 17, he tells us that everything that we have, everything that we're going to have, and everything that we're going to have, it all comes from Him. Every good gift and every perfect gift comes down from above, from the Father of lights, with whom is no variableness, nor shadow of turning. I'm glad to know, praise God, He's a just God. I'm glad to know, praise God, He doesn't pick out the good ones. He doesn't pick out the good ones. You know what? He loves us all.
Praise God.
He loves us all. The unsearchable riches of the kingdom of God is God's love and God's word. He provides in 2 Corinthians chapter 8, verse 9 says, "For you know that the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, that though He was rich, yet for your sake He became poor, that ye through His poverty might be rich." He gives us those physical riches. Every good gift and every, those are physical riches that we get, but He gives us those spiritual riches. You know what? In 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 21 says, "He became sin for us who knew no sin, that we might be made the righteousness of God." you know, what we have, the righteousness of God applied to our life. He said he's in the world, not imputing sin in the world. You know what that means? That means because he's not imputing sin, he's imputing righteousness to our account. I'm glad to know this morning we have the righteousness of the Lord Jesus Christ within us when we believe on his precious name.
Yeah.
What a blessing to know. That's certainly an unsearchable rich, certainly an unspeakable rich that God has given us, that we might know that he is the great I am. Praise God, I'm glad to know this morning that he became sin for us who knew no sin. I'm glad to know this morning that he gave us his word, he gave us his name, he gives us protection, physical protection. Psalm 91:11 says, "For he shall give his angels charge over thee to keep thee in all thy ways. They shall bear thee up in their hands, lest thou dash thy foot against a stone." I want to tell you this morning, the God of all glory gives us angels to watch over us, to take care of us, and to keep us. He gives us each and every one of us have an angel looking over us. I believe with everything that's in me, God knows where every Christian's at this morning. Brother Marty, I believe every single Christian in the world this morning has an angel that looks over their affairs. I believe they have an angel that looks over their places. You know what? Everybody here this morning has been in a place where you could have been killed. I thought about Brother Billy whenever I studied this. You know what? He was in a place where that tree fell and it caught on his foot, broke his foot. But you know, guess what? You know what? It could have been across his body. It could have been across the top of his head. It could have been anywhere else. But he had an angel looking out for him. He had an angel to direct the path of that thing away from where it was going to do any real big damage. It did enough. But it could have been a lot more, except the God of glory had his hand on me.
Amen.
And what we've all been there.
Yeah.
I've been in places where I know that I could have easily been, Brother Joe, you know, above anybody else probably, that the hand of God kept you away from being destroyed under that car.
That's right.
When that car run over you,
you
had an age. You might suffer a little. You might hurt from now and then. You might have arthritis and all them things. But the God of glory had his hand on you. He knew you was going to be sitting up here singing Jesus at my feet one day. And he kept you for that purpose. You had a guardian angel. I've had them. You've had them. Everybody in here at some time or another. You've been in a place somewhere where your life could have been. I've heard Brother Red talk about some of the things that he did. He had an angel looking out. That's why he's here this morning. Without that guardian angel. Isn't that a great blessing?
Amen.
That we've got somebody right there with us. That's why he told us he'd never leave us and he'll never forsake us, because he's got somebody looking out for us all the time. I'm glad to know he provides everything that we need. He gives us spiritual protection. There in verse 15 he says, I pray not that thou should take them out of the world, but thou should keep them from the evil. He watches, you know what he does? He gives us the Holy Spirit to live within us. We're indwelt by the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
He gives us the Holy Spirit to live right here inside us and to guide us in the way that God. That's why he said what he did. Listen, he said, I pray not that thou should take them out of the world. He didn't ask God the Father to take us out of the world. He asked God the Father to put a hedge of protection around us.
Yeah.
And that's what he's done. He said, listen, he said, but that they should be, that thou should keep them, that thou should keep them from evil. God watches over us. God gives us the Holy Spirit to lead us and to guide us in the way that we ought to go. That's the reason when we get involved, when we're about to get involved in something that we ought not to get in, the Holy Spirit will squeeze that old heart.
Yeah.
And he'll begin to tell you, he'll begin to let you know that you're about to go the wrong way and that you need to turn around and go back the other way and begin. And that's a great rich from Almighty God. That's a great blessing that he gives us. The Holy Spirit to guide us in the way that we ought to go, to lead us and to hold us up and to keep us. Listen, he gives us those provisions. He gives us protection. He gives us his name. He gives us the Word of God. God's Word is quick and powerful and sharper than a two-edged sword. God's Word is able to change the present and the future. What a blessing it is to know that God's Word can change the entire destiny of a man.
Amen.
God's word, this precious word of God, this powerful word of God.
Amen.
Can change the destiny
right.
of a man's future.
Amen.
Listen, God's word is powerful, and God's word is permanent. Isaiah chapter 40, verse 8 says, "The grass withereth and the flower fadeth away, but the word of our God will stand forever."
Amen.
You know what? It'll still be here when everything else is burned up. Yeah. I believe God will keep his word here, even when the earth is melted with fervent heat. I believe his word will still be here. I know it will, as a matter of fact, because the word is God. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. So therefore, even when the earth melts with a fervent heat, the Word will still be here. We'll still have it. Listen, God's Word is it's powerful, and it's permanent, and it's profitable. In 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 16, Brother Steve, all Scripture is given by inspiration of God. And it's what? It's profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, instruction in righteousness. And all Scripture is given by inspiration. Listen, it's profitable. God's Word is powerful. God's Word is permanent. God's Word is profitable. I'm glad this morning that He gives us His Word. And I'm glad this morning that He gives us all kinds of, all the protection that He gives us. In John chapter 10, verse 11, He says, "I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd giveth his life for the sheep." The good shepherd giveth his life for the sheep. I thought about Ronnie Jane used to live in the sheep barn at the University of Kentucky and took care of the sheep. And I've heard him talk about how the sheep, when they go to shear them, Brother Steve, he said, you could just get them and stand them up here and let them lean back against your leg, and they just lay right there and let you shear them all day long. It didn't matter if you, and even, he said, even if you cut their skin or anything, they wouldn't do nothing. They just lay there, let you do whatever you want to. Listen, he said, "I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd giveth his life for the sheep." I'm glad to know, praise God, Jesus Christ came as a Lamb of God to this world.
Amen.
To give his life. Pay my sin debt. One of us. One of the great riches of the kingdom of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ. He gives us his peace. He said, "My peace I give you. Not as the world give unto you. Let not your heart be troubled. Let it not be afraid." And we don't have anything to fear when we put our faith and our trust in Almighty God. When we're leaning on Him and enjoying all the blessings that we have today. We have nothing to fear, Brother Joe. We know that I can go in and lay down and go to sleep. And I can sleep like a baby. Because I know if something happens during the night, I'm going to wake up in glory. Nothing this world can do to me. Ever take it away.
Amen.
Aren't you glad this morning?
I
like Brother Marty's verse over there in Romans and Romans chapter 8. Brother Marty loves those verses, and I do too. If I can find it real quick, I'm going to read them. I didn't really intend to, but in Romans and chapter 8, starting down about verse 30, I think it is. Yeah, "Moreover, whom he did predestinate, them he also called. And whom he called, them he also justified. And whom he justified, them he also glorified. What shall we then say to these things? If God be for us, who can be against us? He that spared not his own son, but delivered him up for us all, how shall we not with him also freely give us all things? Who shall lay anything to the charge of God's elect? It is God that justifies. Who is he that condemneth? It's Christ that died, yea, rather that is risen again, who is even at the right hand of God, also maketh intercession for us.
Thank you.
Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or sword? As it is written, for thy sake we are killed all day long. We are accounted as sheep for the slaughter. Nay, in all these things we are more than conquerors."
That's
what a blessing.
Amen.
Woo! Through him that loved us. Isn't that a great rich from the kingdom of God?
Amen.
God's love.
Divine protection.
Divine protection. Absolutely. He says, "I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus. If that don't give you peace in your heart, you got a problem. A couple of verses on y'all. If you're here this morning, you may be thinking that you were saved sometime way back when you was a little kid.